Hi everyone, it's Daria. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I am trying something new and I will take you on a trip with me as I go shopping for stationery supplies at a very special store at Granville Island. So I want to make a little bit of a series here on YouTube where I'm documenting the city where I live, which is Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. And of course, this being a journaling and scrapbooking channel, I still want to tie that in with my main interest and the main theme of my channel. So I will try to combine these trips with either a little bit of haul videos and kind of shopping for stationery supplies and scrapbooking things, or maybe journaling afterwards and documenting my hometown. So I would really like to create a traveler's notebook where I'm documenting the place where I live, because I think we're dedicating so much time to documenting our trips and other places that we visit, but I really want to remember the kind of everyday beauty and things that maybe I don't notice because I take them for granted, but I would like to remember them. So this is the intention behind this vlog and these new series. And while I was talking, I took you on a little boat ride with me on Aquabus, which is a boat that can take you between different places like downtown Vancouver, Granville Island, Olympic Village, and Science World. And it's a very fast way to travel and it's super fun. It's especially fun in the summer, but even in the winter, you know, I visited in late January and it was raining, but it was still really nice to travel by Aquabus, and it's really quick to get around rather than trying to take the bus or even Uber. It's just so much faster. So Granville Island is a trendy area with lots of shops and restaurants. It has a brewery. It's very touristy. It has many theaters. I've been here to different performances multiple times throughout my 15 years or so living in Vancouver. So I super love this place, but I feel like I don't come here often enough. And I think Vancouverites tend to think, well, it's so touristy, why would I go here? But there's actually many cool places to visit on Granville Island, and I just super love window shopping. I also really appreciate all of the art, because it's definitely a place for artists. And just walking around and looking at different things that are constantly changing is so much fun. So I hope you enjoy wandering around with me. You know, on Granville Island, you can always find something new and things are constantly changing. New restaurants are popping up, but my favorite place to eat is actually the public market. It is a functioning market where you can go shopping for fruits and seafood and meat and, you know, just different eats. And you can either take them with you and cook them, or they have quite a few stalls where they sell prepared things. And you can have lunch, you can have coffee, they will even grind the coffee for you. And of course, they have amazing desserts. Unfortunately, when I was here this time, they had no free tables, so I couldn't sit down and enjoy these pastries, but rest assured that I took some with me to enjoy at home, because of course I couldn't walk away empty-handed. This place is just so delicious. After filling up on tea or coffee and something delicious, it's really fun to walk around. Even when it's raining a little bit, all you need is an umbrella and you can quickly duck in and out of stores. There are so many on Granville Island, and they range from souvenir shops to kind of more niche stores that I think are more like home decor and things like that. I found this place called Make, and they carry kind of quirky little gifts or decorations for your home. Most importantly, they carried stickers and other products by Marcus Hines, who's a local artist here in Vancouver and does art that basically depicts different iconic Vancouver places or places around Vancouver like Victoria and Sea to Sky Highway and things like that. I just love having local art. I actually did buy this East Van Cross because this is a piece of public art in East Vancouver, which is my favorite in the city. And I really wanted to have something to kind of remind me of it. So I thought it would be super fun to have that with me. I saw this hand-drawn Vancouver book that I didn't end up buying, but afterwards I regretted that and I ended up ordering it online, and I'm currently waiting for it to arrive in the mail. I'm super excited because I want to draw more and I'm just curious to see how an artist is depicting the city where I live. I'm hoping to find some inspiration there for my journaling and documenting. And the real reason that I came to Granville Island was because they have an official Travelers Company partner store, which is called Paper Ya. And it's a stationery store that has partnered up with the Travelers Company in Japan and is carrying their products and also has their limited products that are not sold in other places. I was super excited to be here. They had lots of cute things, washi, all of the good stuff, but I resisted and I only got a few Traveler's Notebook inserts, stickers from local artists, a few cards, and I had to get the stamp for my notebooks because they have the limited stamps, or they're actually not limited, they're exclusive to these stores, so it's very exciting to have your notebook stamped by them. So I'm going to follow up on this with the haul video so that you can see all of the goodies that I grabbed on this trip, but I think I'm going to be back to the store probably sooner rather than later just because I was so happy to be there. It was just the best day ever. And now I'm very inspired to document this trip and also start documenting the place where I live. So I'm hoping to start a notebook that's going to be a home for all of these stories and all of these little memories that I maybe wouldn't necessarily document otherwise, but I think it's very important. You know, it's my home, it's the place where I live, it's beautiful, and I really want that recorded somewhere and documented for the future, especially because I do plan to move in not too far future. So I'd like to have a memory of the place where I used to live at some point later on. So anyways, I hope you have enjoyed this little vlog. This is my first one, but there will be more to follow. And I hope you are as excited about them as I am, because I am very excited. Thank you so much for watching, and now I will go on to the haul. Hello friends. Thank you so much for joining me on my trip to Granville Island. I hope you like that. And right now I want to show you all of the goodies that I picked up at Paper Ya, which is a stationery store that's an official Travelers Company partner store, and it's the only one here in Vancouver, Canada that is a partner. And I did go to one other store to pick up a few stickers, but Paper Ya actually carries them as well. So, of course, the main thing that I got was my very first Traveler's Notebook cover in the camel cover. I have been wanting this one for so long, and it's definitely a bit of a splurge, but I have been documenting in Traveler's Notebooks pretty consistently over the past almost a year, and I know I'm going to continue, so I thought it would be worth it. Obviously this cover will last me years and years, and I'll use it for a different project. I'll bring it with me on my trips, so I'm very excited to have it. This is definitely my favorite color, camel, and I don't have any charms yet, but I am of course planning to get something to put on this elastic outside, or maybe even here. And inside is just, you know, it has a plain Traveler's Notebook insert. I believe it's 64 pages. I decided to invest in a few new inserts because I obviously have a bunch from different companies and some random ones I got on Amazon, but the quality of those wasn't the best. And a lot of the scrapbooking companies sell printed traveler's notebooks, so often we'll have an image here and maybe some lined paper or dog grid here, but I wanted something that would be completely blank so that I can, you know, doodle or do something more exciting in it. I just want a little bit less of a prescribed format, if that makes sense. So I'm very excited to start in like a classic, genuine traveler's notebook for my documenting. And because the store that I went to, Paper Ya, is a partner store, they do have the official Travelers Company partner stamp. So you can have your visit pass here and put a date. These are just the practice sheets. They gave me some pieces of paper to practice on, and I love it. It has an image of Granville Island. This is under the Granville Bridge as you enter Granville Island, and it says Vancouver, Canada, and the name of the store. It's so adorable. And right now, because the Travelers Diner limited set had just come out, they, as a partner shop, of course, have the diner stamp. I love that it's red. I was so excited that I was able to get this one as well. They did actually have two more Travelers Diner sets that are basically sold out everywhere, but I decided that I'm not gonna get it. I have debated it, but I wanted to get the classic one, because as much as I love the diner theme, this one is just gonna be more useful for me. And so it was a hard decision, but I didn't splurge on it. But I did buy a lot of inserts and I stamped a few of them. So this one is just a blank refill. I got a few of these, but this is the one that I stamped, and I wanted to do on a second page so I can kind of work it into my layout. I got the ones that are watercolor paper because I want to try to doodle on them. And let me see what we have here. Yeah, so I put just the store stamp. I didn't put the diner one because I think this one will be just more of a generic. I might just doodle some stuff in my city and things like that. So I wanted it to be just like a Vancouver notebook. But it is, I like that it's like this off-white color. It's very nice. And I also bought refills for a short trip. So I think I got about like maybe two of the watercolor one and three of the other ones, because I know I'm going to use them a lot. So the short trip is like half size, and I stamped here on the back. I might actually document like weekend trips or things like that in these notebooks, because then obviously you can put them in covers and stack them like three or four in one binder. So that would be pretty cool. So I might do that. And because the salesperson at Paper Ya saw how excited I was about everything, and I was like very grateful that they let me stamp all the things, and I was just so happy to be there. So after I stamped my stuff and I was getting ready to leave, she gave me this envelope. It says Travelers Company. I love it. I don't know what I'm going to use it for because it's so nice. I'm going to try not to hoard it. I might actually put it in one of my like scrapbook binders or something like that. I can attach it either by punching holes or maybe just with like a plastic attacher with like a 6-hole punch. We'll see. I have some ideas for it, but I think it's a really good one for like ephemera and stuff, but I wouldn't bring it on a trip with me because it's paper, so I'm afraid that it would get ruined. I usually get the plastic envelopes for these purposes. She also gave me this very cute sticker that says happy holidays and have a nice trip, Travelers Factory. I think this is just a leftover from what they had over Christmas. And I'm just so grateful, and I was so happy yesterday. Like it was a highlight of like, I don't know, my week. It was great. I loved it. So thank you so much to the wonderful people at Paper Ya. Of course, I will link the shop down below. If you are ever in Vancouver, make sure that you visit them. And yeah, it's an amazing store. I also picked up some Vancouver postcards. So this is, I think the artist's name is here, Anya Jane, I believe, is the name of the person. I'm going to hold it up so that you can see. So I love the style,
And this is by the same person. So this is obviously not from Vancouver. Banff is the national park in Alberta. And this is where Lake Louise and all of the gorgeous lakes are that, you would usually go visit in Canada. I did a trip a couple of years ago and I still need to scrapbook it, but I want to include, I didn't bring any ephemera from that trip because I didn't scrapbook back then. So I wanted something with like the Banff name on it, and I decided that I would use this just as a journaling card, but I think it's really cute. And yeah, I just love this the style of the paintings. And I also got one like graphic postcard, and it's just a map of Vancouver, and I think it's really cute. I think it's actually meant to be this way. Yeah, this is the downtown, and this is like the Vancouver proper, North Vancouver, Richmond, and then you go Burnaby and other things over there. So yeah, it's very cool to have this. And I also picked up some stickers. So this one, I actually don't think it is like any artist. I think this is just a mass-produced one as far as I understood. But these stickers are by a local Vancouver artist. I know his first name is Marcus, and I don't know. Oh yeah, Marcus Heinz. So I will actually link the Etsy shop down in the description, because you can buy these stickers on Etsy. It just so happened that I was going to a store where they sell them. They actually sell them in a few places on Granville Island, but I already had it in my mind that I wanted these stickers, so I was looking for them specifically, and I was very happy to find them. So this is East Vancouver. Obviously you have the Vancouver special house, which is this like type of architecture that we have here. They're not particularly pretty, but this is like a classic Vancouver house. And you have the crow in the foreground, and you have all these houses, and then the greenery, of course, because Vancouver is so green. And you have the East Van sign, which is like my favorite piece of public art in Vancouver. And then you have the downtown and the mountains, and of course the setting sun out west over the ocean, and some clouds, because we almost always have clouds. But I super love this sticker, and I'm definitely going to use it for journaling. These are vinyl stickers, so you can actually use them on like laptop and water bottle and stuff, but I want them specifically to journal about my city. There's also Beer Island sticker overlooking Canada Place in the downtown, and you can see the Falls Creek, and there's a bike here and some people with backpacks. It's really cute. And there's a few local ones as well. So Victoria, which is our capital here in British Columbia, and it has the government building, again the mountains with the sun setting over the ocean, and there's so many flowers, so Victoria has lots of flowers. And the last one is the Sea to Sky Country sticker. So Sea to Sky is a highway in British Columbia between Vancouver and Whistler, and I think it actually goes past Whistler, but I haven't been there, so I'm not entirely sure. But basically, it's the most beautiful road you can ever drive on, because it has mountains to one side, and then it has the ocean to the other side, and then you see the mountains across the water, and it has all the trees and stuff, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. It's such a beautiful drive, so if you ever come to BC, make sure that you do that. And I, of course, wanted a sticker of Sea to Sky. And that's basically it for my haul, so not too much, but these are the things that I'm so incredibly excited about. So again, I had a great time shopping at Paper Yeah. I can't believe I've never shopped there before. I'm definitely going to be back as soon as I can. And if you guys have any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, I'll be back soon with some layouts in my traveler's notebook. I cannot wait to start working in it. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, and please consider subscribing for my future videos. Have a great day. Bye.